Hey, what's up guys, welcome back to the channel, and in this video, we're going to take a look at a customized way to make camera shake in After Effects. So we're going to be using some slider controls and expressions, but it's very, very simple. Hope you guys enjoy it, let's get started. Alright, so what I've got here is a visual effects shot of a spaceship coming in through some low-level clouds and fog, and right now the camera is a lock-off, so it's not moving, but I want to add a little bit more life into the shot by adding some camera shake. So you could use this to mimic a more handheld type of shot to add vibration to something, or make it look as if there's some kind of disturbance in the air. So in this case, I want to make this ship look a little bit more impressive, and camera shake is going to give me that type of effect. So what I'm going to do, close down this, I'm going to make a new null object, and you're going to type in camera shake. Next, we're going to go into our effects and presets, and we're looking for a slider control. Add a slider control, and we're going to duplicate it. And we're adding slider controls to be able to animate the position of an expression. So we're going to be using a wiggle expression, and traditionally you'll just put in single integers for the two parameters. One is going to be frequency, and the second one is going to be intensity, but it doesn't give you the option to animate it. So by replacing those integers with a simple slider control, it's very easy to do that. So on this first one here, we're going to click enter, and then type in frequency. And this is going to be for the position channel. And the second one is going to be intensity, which is also for position. So next I'm going to click P on the keyboard. I'm going to hold down the Alt key on the stopwatch and type in wiggle. So the first parameter of the wiggle function is going to be the frequency. We're going to take this pick whip, go up to slider and let go, then do a comma. And then we're going to grab the pick whip again and attach the second parameter to the intensity position slider. So what we've just done, instead of putting numbers here, we've referenced whatever our slider is. So right now they're both zero, but this is going to change in a moment. So in order to actually see any effect at all, what we're going to need to do, take however many layers that you have that need to have the camera shake applied to them, and you need to parent it to the camera shake layer. And what I recommend that you do, if you are applying camera shake for a visual effects shot or something for a client, or even for yourself for some kind of personal project, what I recommend is to render out the shot without any camera shake at all, and then apply camera shake to a already rendered version. So this is going to make it much, much faster just to play around with shake, because camera shake can be quite tricky to get right, to get the motion just down properly. And clients often want a clean version and a camera shake version when you submit final frames to them. So it just makes it a little bit faster for you, or quite a bit faster actually, instead of having to go back to the main comp and render out the entire thing again, just with camera shake. So in this case, I have everything else shied, and I just rendered out this comp with all the effects on it, so I didn't have to wait for it to take forever to render again with camera shake. Anyway, so if you had multiple layers, you can attach them all easily. Otherwise, just attach this single layer to camera shake. So on the camera shake layer, if we play this forward, since both of these are zero, nothing's gonna happen. So let's add something like 2 for the frequency, which means this could change 2 times per second. And the intensity is how many pixels this could move per second. It could move 10 pixels per second. So this is pretty slow, pretty light camera motion, but I want this to ramp up speed. I'm gonna reset both of these values, and at the very beginning, it's gonna set this to 0. And then let's say by frame 350, this can go a little bit more intense. So maybe for the frequency, we'll do something like 5 times per second. And the number of pixels it can move, maybe we could say 20. That might be a little bit too much, but we'll find out in a moment. And then by the end, we can have this kind of fade off. So put the intensity back down to 0, and the frequency also can go down to 0. Now, the frequency and the intensity, you don't necessarily need to animate both of these channels. You can get away with just doing frequency or just doing intensity probably. In this case, I'm just gonna do both, see what we've got here. So something like that could work pretty well. Now, one thing you will notice that this is going to cut in, and we're gonna get a black edge around this. And there is honestly nothing you can do about that besides scaling up the plate or scaling up anything that's attached to this camera shake layer. So what I'm going to do now is hold down the shift key and click S to open up the scale attribute as well. And what you have to do is just scale this up a little bit, maybe 5%, and you're just going to have to check to see if that was enough. If you are filming something and you know you're going to be adding camera shake, make sure you leave enough room to be able to crop in, because using camera shake requires a crop. Unless you're doing something that's very, very subtle and you could kind of animate in the scale, that's fine, but most of the time that's not really a viable option, because it just looks a bit weird to do that. Anyway, so we could play around with this this in a second, but I want to add rotation as well. So I'm going to shift select R to open up the rotation channel, and I'm going to grab two more slider controls, and these are going to be frequency and intensity for rotation. Same thing, we're going to hold down Alt on the rotation channel, type in wiggle, grab the frequency rotation slider, comma, and then the intensity rotation slider. Now for rotation, you want to use very, very slight adjustments because the rotating a lot is going to look very, very odd. So I wouldn't recommend going above 2 degrees. So I'll say up here, at the very beginning, we can just say this is at zero. Both of these can be at zero. And then at 350 again, maybe the rotation frequency can still be at 5, but then the intensity is only going to be at 2. And then here it's going to be 0 and 0. Okay, so these values are a little bit off. There's no parallax, so it looks a little bit strange that it goes so intense. So I'm just going to lower these values for the intensity there. And then for frequency, I'm going to say the maximum is going to be 3. And the maximum intensity for rotation, maybe just 1 degree. Although you could increase the intensity just a bit as well for the position. Allow the camera just to sway a little bit more. Something like that could work. And what I'm going to do here, I'm going to smooth out these keyframes at the very beginning. Going to allow that to more gradually ramp up. Might do the same down here as well. Allow these to kind of fade away. I'm going to leave this linear. So as you play around with this, you might have to just play around with different levels of intensity and frequency, but this method is pretty useful. There's also plugins that do more or less the same type of thing. You might find that a little bit easier to use, but this is a good free option. One thing to note though, if you are going to add camera shake, you have to add motion blur as well. So I have the motion blur switch enabled, and it's enabled for the comp as well. If you don't do that, it looks like something is wrong. And the idea here is always to make it look like the camera was shooting this and it's not necessarily a visual effects shot, even though if it is pretty evident that it would be, you're always trying to match what the camera would see. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching. If you learned something, drop a like. If you have any questions, post a comment, and I'll be back soon with another video. Peace.